questions there. Those are your top stories for 7:30. Let's head back to the desk.
Thank you very much, Chris. And Sid Ryan is here. He is the president of the Ontario Federation of Labor. Good morning.
It's great to be here.
Some disturbing news that you put out yesterday in this report called Falling Behind, Ontario's Backslide into Widening Inequality, Growing Poverty, and Cuts to Social Programs. You say that Ontario is the province with the largest gap between the rich and the poor.
That's right. What we did here was, it's a collection of 90 organizations, a lot of them the community partners plus labor. We've actually taken information that's already existing out there, such as Stats Canada, various reports from different organizations, poverty organizations, that have already highlighted all these issues. But what we did was we pulled them all together in one document and then basically held up a mirror to ourselves and said, how do we stack up against the rest of the country? And those indices that we measured were dead last in practically all of them. So
what kind of things were you looking at specifically?
Well, one of the things obviously is the inequality in income. The top 10% essentially over the last 10 years, when we've had like a real economic boom in Ontario, are galloping away with the wealth in the province. The top 10% earn more than the bottom 40%, but the bottom 40% actually have stagnated in terms of income, and over the last 10 years they've essentially seen their income remain stagnant. The corporate CEOs and the top 10%, they earn 250 times more than the bottom 40%, and only 15 years ago that was only about 25 times more. So you can see the gap is beginning to grow exponentially.
What would you like to see change?
Well, one of the things we'd like to see, obviously, is around the taxation. One of the things that the government is doing with their recent budget is strictly looking at cutting services and cutting programs, social programs, which helps to make the inequality even more pronounced. What we'd like to see is to say, okay, there should be some cuts in services. We're not saying that we should not be looking at that side of the equation, but you also have to look at the revenue side. And when McGuinty gave some instructions to Don Drummond to take a look at the fiscal problem in the province, he said to him, do not look at revenue. And we're saying that's ridiculous. How could any household sit down and only look at spending and not look at what you're wearing?
You did put a pause to cap corporate tax rates. And what you're calling for here in all your recommendations is higher corporate taxes, mm-hmm. Higher taxes for anybody making over $300,000 mm-hmm. a year. Those on the right of the spectrum are going to say that you're just trying to tax and spend here. And look what happened in London with Caterpillar. That company decided, look, the corporate or the tax regime here in this country is not good enough. We're going to move our business elsewhere.
Okay. I'm not so sure that they moved because of the tax regime. They actually said we're moving because of wages. And they found a cheaper home down in Indiana. But, you know, Mark Carney from the governor of the Bank of Canada and Jim Flaherty only yesterday came out, and they did the same thing about a week ago, slamming the corporate sector, saying you're sitting on $500 trillion worth of capital. Primarily came out of tax breaks, taxpayers' money, really. And they're not investing it back into creating jobs, putting Canadians back to work. So in other words, this whole nonsense about trickle down from giving taxes to corporations and they'll create jobs and we'll all be happy has not worked. It's a failed policy. And yet we continue to shovel money at corporations instead of saying, why don't we invest in ourselves, invest in post-secondary education. This is a wonderful opportunity right now in a time to be educating young people through our university system, making our system more affordable. We are the highest tuition fees of any university system anywhere in Canada. So we make that more affordable so as more kids can go to school, more kids from working class families have an opportunity to get a university degree so as we can, you know, prepare our kids for the next generation of jobs.
Okay, but Sid, let's talk numbers here. You say that the top 10%, what are they making? What's the average family making? And who's the bottom 40%? What are they making?
Well, the average income in a family is about $73,000. The bottom 10% are living just marginally above the poverty level, which is about $21,000 a year. There's 600,000 families trapped in that poverty trap, basically, finding it really difficult to get out. 393,000 children are actually living in poverty. That's 1 in 7 kids in Ontario are living in poverty. And in Hamilton, the Social Planning Council took a report, they applied it to Hamilton, and they're saying in Hamilton, 1 in 4 children are living in poverty.
Well, so thanks for coming by, and it's certainly important to get this debate happening.
Yeah, no, that's what it's all about. Get the discussion going, and hopefully governments, we can put a pressure on them to start looking at something else besides just cutting programs. How about starting to invest in our future and in our social programs?
Sid Ryan, president of the Ontario Federation of Labor. Nice talking to you this
morning.
Great,
thank you very much.
We're going to take a break at 7:42. We'll see you in just a minute.
Good.